I knew you would return before long. And it seems you have done as Valentina asked. You see, even with a glass ball, the great Kalderasha's eyes see further than you realize. But you are meddling in matters that do not concern you. And you are wasting your time. You can bring back my crystal ball as many times as you like. I will just throw it away again. What? Don't throw things in the waterfall. It might open up an old wound. What on earth are you talking about? Enough. Listen to me. No one knows why I threw away my crystal ball. Even Valentina has no idea. I'm not about to confide in a stranger. Give it to me! This time I will smash it into a million pieces, so it never finds its way back to me again!
Stop! Please stop, Father! I know. I've known for ages. I know why you threw away your crystal ball.
You know? So you know about your real parents?
Yes. And I don't blame you for their death.
Why not? How can you not blame me, Valentina? How can you not hate me?
Because you were just fortune-telling. Just doing what you do best. I was too young to remember, but you were once a truly great fortune teller, weren't you, Father? No one knew where my parents had fled to, but to you, it was as clear as day.
Ah. Back then, there was nothing I could not see. The great Kalderasha was known all over the world. I was walking on air. Fortune-telling was my life. It was my soul. I thought only of myself. Be they good or bad, I cared not who asked me to use my crystal ball. I lived for the vision.
It's all right, Father. You're a good man. You took me in and raised me, didn't you? When I was just a helpless baby. I want to see it for myself. I want to see the great Kalderasha in all his glory. I want to see your magnificent powers at work again, Father.
Oh, my sweet Valentina. So, you are awake at last. It is already past midday. You must have been exhausted. I must thank you and your friend. Look, I have put my crystal ball back where it belongs. Many years have passed since I gazed into the crystal like this. I have to thank you for returning it to me. What is this? Yes, yes, I see it, I see it. There is a jester breaking through the southern checkpoint. Yes, the mists are clearing. And the same jester murdered Master Rylus. Yes, yes, the mists are clearing. Can it be? Surely not. He has changed, but there can be no mistake. It has to be Master Rylus's former pupil, Dulmagos.
What?
Gov, he said Dulmagos, right? That's our man. That's the evil magician you and the old granddad are after, innit? So where'd he go after that? What else can you deduct?
What else? Let me look deeper. Huh? What's this? Yes, no question. This is definitely my old crystal ball, but look here. It has been chipped. Huh. It must have hit something very hard to do this damage. And look! Someone has scratched some letters next to the chip. What? Halfwit? Who's the halfwit? What ignorant lowlife would do this to my crystal ball?
You what? When I ask what else you could see, I didn't mean on the ball, I meant in the ball. Whatever. I'll come and gov. Thank you.
What happened? Did you do what the young girl asked? Well? What? Dulmagus killed Master Rylus? The same Dulmagus we're looking for? That fiend killed his own teacher? And you say he headed south? Then there's no time to lose. We must go after him at once. Let's be on our way.
Thank you. We'll be right back. this, you brass scoundrels! I can spot bandits a mile off! This is for Alistair! Come on, Mash! Let's get them!
Yes, sir, Bangerz!
Prepare to meet your maker!
What on earth are you two rascals up to now? Stop it at once. Where are your manners? That's no way to welcome travelers.
Ow!
Ow!
Didn't Miss Jessica ask you to run an errand for her? And here you are playing around.
I forgot!
You'd better run along before Jessica finds out.
Yikes!
I'm so sorry. They don't mean any harm. It's just that our village has been through a lot lately. Ask around for yourselves. You'll see. There's nothing wrong with the place, mind. It's a lovely village, really. Make yourselves at home.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I don't know who will find this letter, but please consider it my last will and testament. For by the time you read this, I will already be gone. I am going to the tower in the east. I will not return until my brother's death is avenged. Mother, I'm sorry for the damage I've caused to our family's reputation. But this is about something far bigger than tradition. I must follow my heart, no matter the consequences. Please forgive me. And to Bangerz and Mash, I'm sorry for lying to you. I hope you'll forgive me as well. Signed, Jessica. I don't know who will find this letter, but please consider it my last will and testament. I am going to the tower in the east. Mother, I'm sorry for the damage I've caused to our family. I must follow my heart, no matter. And to Bangerz and Mash, I'm sorry for lying to you.
What? A letter from Jessica? No way! You're lying! She's been in our room the whole time! So how could she give you a letter?
I don't know. It sounds sort of real to me.
Okay, fine. I'll check her room. But if I'm right, You better leave and never come back! Got it? Right, just wait here! No running away now! Hey! She is gone! Jessica's handwriting. But if she really did go to the tower, she'll end up just like her brother, Alistair. This is bad. This is really bad. We've got to do something. We've got to get her out of there. You! This is partly your fault. So, I'll open the door to the tower. You go in and get her. Got it? Okay, we've got to hurry to get to the tower. Go left down the path outside the village. Oh, one more thing. I'll leave the monsters to you lot. Listen, Mash, whatever you do, don't let Jessica's mum find out where she went.
Yes, sir, Bangerz.
Good. Come on, we've got to hurry!
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Don't believe me. Looks like you trust me. Sorry for doubting you. This is an emergency, so I'll show you how to open the door. But you have to promise never to tell anyone. Okay, here we go. Open Sesame! Pretty cool, eh? It opens from the bottom. Well, this is as far as I'm going. I'll head back to the village now. You help Jessica.
Thank you. Thank you.
You! I knew you'd be back for the jewels. You killed my brother. Now you'll suffer the same fate. You're fast. I guess thieves need to be quick on their toes. But you won't get away from me this time.
Wait! Jessica, it's me. Don't you recognize my voice?
Alistair?
Stay your spell, Jessica. I wasn't slain at their hands.
Stay my spell? But it's too late! Alistair? Alistair? Is that really you?
It's me, Jess. You have to listen to me, as do you travelers. After I died, a part of my soul was allowed to linger in this statue. Even now as I speak to you, the power keeping me here begins to evaporate. Time is short. Look into the statue's eyes. The truth lies within. Hurry! The day I died, the door to the tower was already open. I thought it was strange, so I decided to look around and see for myself. That's when I saw him.
Who are you?
Such a pity.
Pity? What are you talking about? Who are you? Answer me!
Me? I am Dul Magus, and I was referring to the fragility of human life.
Fragility? What do you mean? My sword! I can't draw my sword!
I said such a pity. A terrible pity that a shining young star like you should chance to encounter me.
What have you done? To me! Dul Magus! I won't
forget this!
What? You won't forget my name? You're too kind. I shall return the favor and remember yours as well. Now, let us finish this before I feel any more pity.
Doommakers!
It has been an honor making your acquaintance. You may rest assured, your death will not be in vain.
And now you have seen what the statue saw, my traveling friends. I don't understand it myself, but it seems the statue of Alexandra has been awaiting your arrival. If the memory of my tale can serve you on your quest, it would bring great relief to my soul. My stay here is coming to an end. It's time for us to part. One final thing, Jess. Mother may try to stand in your way. Nevertheless, follow your heart and do as you must. Farewell, my little sister.
Tragic affair. There can be no question. This is Dolmegas' treachery.
Oh, blimey!
It would appear that Alistair also wishes us to bring Dolmegas to justice. His sacrifice shall not be in vain. Now, we have yet another reason to stop Dolmegas' foul reign of terror. I shall await you by the carriage. Cheerio!
I really must apologize for my behavior. We'll talk more later, but I need to be alone right now. I'll see you back at the village.
Thank you.